The Los Angeles Film School is a one-year associate's degree in film production, and the school covers every area of film production. So it goes writing, producing, directing, cinematography, production design, editing, sound, the whole gamut. And every student gets the same education. The production design part of the Los Angeles Film School's filmmaking program initially started with hand drafting. But because SketchUp is so important to the film industry, we had to include it in our program. And SketchUp has become one of the more popular programs for pre-visualizing.
When we first meet the students, a lot of them have never drafted before or designed anything really before. So what we do is we take them through the whole motions of two-dimensional and three-dimensional design. Then we introduce them to SketchUp, and then we show them how easy it is for them to take their ideas from paper, put them on computer, and how easy it is to manipulate it from that point onwards.
I graduated from the program in 2005, and at that time I learned SketchUp, and I've been using it ever since. I've just found that it really helps me visually communicate all the facets that I need to a director in three-dimensional space, which is really important that SketchUp can do that. Where as a piece of paper you can only show one angle at a time, in the computer I can build the full thing and then spin it around, show them the other angle, and show them what's going to work and what's not.
SketchUp was the first introduction we could actually do in set building, because we do teach it in a way that almost shows you how to build a set. When we're pulling up walls, and we can keep every element of the set in groups so that we can take it apart. Because ultimately you will take a set apart and you will change it, because sets are constantly are being changed, because there's always more needs or the director has other ideas.
I find that it's a very, very easy way to get ideas on paper. And now I'm at the point where I use SketchUp all the time. I don't draft anymore.
SketchUp works well in interior design for a variety of reasons. One, it's so easy to model, so you can quickly test different design ideas and different design options. The other reason I use SketchUp is, especially now with the 3D warehouse, it's really quick and easy to accurately represent your design, whether it's with furniture or a certain type of furniture or a certain type of product. There's so much available in 3D warehouse, it's really helpful. And then the other reason that it seems to be really useful is using the material browser and the ability to add materials quickly and change materials quickly. A big way students use SketchUp is they'll model their CAD drawings in SketchUp, and they'll use SketchUp and some other CAD program to turn their two-dimensional ideas into three-dimensional models. Another way we're using SketchUp is we're using the wide array of aftermarket plugins that we can put into SketchUp to create more photorealistic type renderings. And this is super exciting for myself and for students, because the cost is so efficient rather than buying a program that's $3,000 or $4,000 or $5,000. A problem I think students have in any design program is they put so much time and energy into a design that they don't ever want to back out of it. But with SketchUp, you can test ideas over and over, and you can back out of an idea really easily without having invested so much time and energy into it.
So I've been stunned sometimes at final presentations what the students are producing in SketchUp, when I know at the beginning of the semester they were introduced to the program.
I think where it really shines, in my opinion, is in the early stages of a design project. Again, massing is so easy. I don't know any program that masses things easier than SketchUp. From a program point of view, we use it all the time to map out size of things, and you can figure out how big certain areas need to be, and those can become essentially placeholders in SketchUp, colorful boxes that we can start to lay out the program. And that actually leads to some very exciting discoveries, and also to some really novel ways of presenting that information. How we can actually show three-dimensionally, we can quickly go through lots of variations and iterations. So that's, I think, is one of the big advantages of SketchUp early on in the process.
It's great for students to be able to develop a fly-through, because this unfolding of experience and the progression through different spaces, there's nothing better than to let the students build a little movie of what it's like when they first enter the site. It's one thing to read about something in a book, and it's completely different to have them go in and see how their ideas can be reflected in the built environment. And SketchUp's the easiest, most accessible tool I know of to do that.
And the great thing about SketchUp is that it's there, it's right at your fingertips. You can set up your coordinates correctly, and then essentially, you know, you can do a very accurate shadow analysis, which I think is absolutely crucial nowadays.
For them to be able to walk through and understand that sequence of experiences, I think it really increases that learning curve. Having a tool like SketchUp, because our brains were so visual, that to gain this instant understanding of what they're doing, it makes them better designers, and it makes our job easier. Maybe the students are getting a little spoiled because it's pretty sophisticated, the power that they have at their fingertips, but it's great.